You're telling for me though. Okay, so it says, thus says the Lord, my servant shall eat. Okay. 12 here, it says, therefore will I number you to the sword, and ye shall bow down to the slaughter. Because when I called, ye did not answer. But when I spoke, ye heard, and when I spoke, ye heard, ye did not hear, but did evil before my eyes, and then choose that which I delighted not, what I delighted not. So right now, our people are making choices. They're running to Egypt, they're running to Europe, they're running everywhere out of fear. And I'm saying right now that everyone that's running everywhere and not running to Zion, there's a death decree. This is a death decree upon you. Because the scripture says that everyone that don't turn to Zion, there's a death decree upon you. But the people that the scripture also goes off into is talking about the people that remain in the place in which the Most High had scattered them, those people from the four corners of the earth, he's going to draw them. So if this scripture is talking about people, a remnant, one of a city, two of a family that come to Zion, but it's also talking about, it also makes known and makes a reference to the people that remain in that place, then what? Who's this death decree on? It says it's the people that chose that which I delighted not in, that went someplace other than where they were cast out, and not Zion. They went to South America. People in South America that were Hebrews, they went to America. Or the people that was Hebrews that was in Africa, they went to India. Anywhere else but Zion. So there's only two choices we have here, my brothers. Either remain where you are at and wait for God to come and get you, or come up to Zion. But if you go anywhere, to Egypt, to Lebanon, to Syria, to wherever, even in the land of Israel. If you come here to Dimona, to Mount Hermon, or wherever you feel that salvation, if you don't come to Zion, which is according to the word, there's a death decree on you. And if you come to Zion, the Most High promises salvation. Because he says clearly, there's deliverance in Zion. So now, we just want you to join the people that have, that are in the land, that was born in this land, our Jewish brothers, that the scripture says is a third with Israel. And among this group, you're going to see Ethiopians. You're going to see children from Ashur. And you're going to see Hebrew Israelites like myself. And the scripture goes off and to say that there was going to be three people. It says, Egypt, my people. Assyria, the works of my hand, which is the people, the main people that you see has been given this land. And Israel, my inheritance, which you see standing before you right now. And these are the main three people that you're going to see here today coming before the house of God with their offerings. Peace.